on this edition of One Championship Weekly. On the 7th of April, One Championship guarantees another night of blockbuster action with One on TNT I. You're watching One Championship Weekly. On the 7th of April, One kicks off a season of primetime events on TNT with the greatest flyweight contests in mixed martial arts history. Six-time One Flyweight World Champion Adriano Moraes puts his title on the line against One Flyweight World Grand Prix Champion and number one flyweight contender Demetrious Johnson. In 2017, Moraes unified the One Flyweight World title with a definitive win over Kairat Akhmetov. Mikino avenged his split decision loss to Akhmetov, proving once and for all that he is the undisputed king of the One Flyweight division. Let's look back at Adriano's career-defining bout against the Kazakh. We join the action in round five.
Ready?
Final round!
Fight! Fifth and final round for the Flyweight Championship of the World.
But if this goes to his decision, that historic streak might be halted by Moraes.
High inside thigh kick from Akhmetov. Moraes' back leg has been a real weapon tonight. And he switches stance to southpaw, very side on. Is he going to launch the left roundhouse kick here? Thought about a turning kick, and Uchido Geri. Switching stance constantly now, confounding the champion, making him guess, making him wonder which way is he going to go? What stance is he going to use? What's he going to throw next? It's a roundhouse off the right.
At this point, I do believe that Akhmetov's got to finish the interim champion to get the win if he wants to extend that streak to 24-0. Moraes has got the single leg. Let's see how Akhmetov is able to defend.
It was a driving single leg attempt that Akhmetov managed to stop. Moraes still looks for the takedown. Now he gets it. One butterfly hook lifting him there. And Moraes on top of Akhmetov.
Nicely done.
Double butterfly hooks now from the champion, controlling Moraes' posture. Little palm heel strike there
holding,
from Adriano Moraes. Don't see them often, but they are effective. More palm heel strikes to the side of the head from Moraes.
Akhmetov trying to control the posture of Moraes so he's not able to posture up and drop any heavy ground and pound. He's got the feet on the hips, trying to elevate Moraes out so he can possibly break away.
Akhmetov comes in tonight, 23 fights in a row he has won. It is incredible. But he may be staring down the barrel of his first ever loss. It would be monumental for Adriano Moraes to be that man who dethrones the champion and who stops history being made on Akhmetov's record.
Go work.
He's almost trying to work past the half guard, but Akhmetov's got a really good guard, and Moraes is a high-level black belt, so if he's not able to pass it, you know, this is high-level jiu-jitsu right here. You can see him trying to control the head, avoiding a lot of damage. Moraes isn't doing a lot on top. A little bit of head strikes right there, but it's not really adding up. It's not going to do any damage. But Moraes, he's
watch out.
Defending well as Akhmetov threw it, but a possible armbar right there.
The interim champion wants the true belt around his waist, and he's doing it at the moment. The seconds are ticking down as time becomes the enemy of Akhmetov. Moraes, a Naganogi champion in 2014, showing off his BJJ stylings here in the final round.
Almost past the guard now. Looks like he's worked his way into side control. Now this is the biggest advantage we've seen on the ground from Moraes. What can he do now that he has side control position?
Dominance here from Adriano Moraes, avenging his loss last time, the controversial loss, and doing so in style. Knees to the body, knees to the head from side control. Relentless here from Adriano Moraes.
This is textbook Brazilian jiu-jitsu, Michael. He's got the hip controlled on one side. Look, now he's gonna try to take that left hand around the other head there. His control is just so dominant on top.
The repertoire, the martial arts skill set we've seen from Moraes tonight has been phenomenal. We've seen capoeira, we've seen Brazilian jiu-jitsu, we've seen kickboxing, Muay Thai and judo. We've seen boxing, the complete mixed martial arts from Moraes tonight, Mick.
He has done it. He has shown a complete range of mixed martial arts skills, and now he is just putting an exclamation point on it right here by controlling an area where he was dominated in the first fight. I shouldn't say dominated, but controlled.
You can see why they call him the Black Diamond, because this is a polished performance. Akhmetov now, it may be desperation time. The champion goes firing. Can he light himself up for the final 25 seconds? It's going to take something special to turn the tide here for the champion, Akhmetov.
It's gonna take a little bit of time to set up a possible submission here. He might wanna let him stand back up and he'll go, you know, wishing for a knockout.
Is there one big top thumper left for Kairat Akhmetov? He throws the hook and Moraes takes him down. He owns him in the final seconds. A big takedown as the interim champion just become the true world champion again.
What a fight. Adriano Moraes, the interim champion. His team believes he's done enough. Celebration on top of the shoulders. Let's take a look at some of this action. That was a beautiful single leg. He had it between the legs, steps over, sweeps around, gets the trip. And here's just some of this dominant side control, a little bit of ground and pound. But then this is the final button right there to be pushed. Shoots in, gets the takedown, exclamation point.
Let's go to Dominic Lau with our official decision.
All three judges have scored in favor of your winner by unanimous decision. And now, the undisputed ONE Championship Flyweight World Champion from the blue corner, Adriano Moraes.
What a moment here for Adriano Moraes. What a performance from the Black Diamond from Brazil. Once again, championship gold about to go around his waist.
Demetrious Mighty Mouse Johnson challenges Adriano Moraes for the ONE Flyweight World title. You're watching ONE Championship Weekly. Welcome back to ONE Championship Weekly. On the 7th of April, Demetrious Johnson looks to cement himself as the mixed martial arts GOAT by claiming the ONE Flyweight World title. Johnson made waves in the mixed martial arts world when he transferred to ONE Championship in a historic trade. To get a shot at the belt, the 12-time world champion took part in the ONE Flyweight World Grand Prix. He debuted in the quarterfinal against Japanese knockout artist Yuya Wakamatsu, and showed the world why he's considered the greatest of all time.
Johnson bounds out of his corner.
You can see a little bit of damage on the right eye of DJ. Those punches from Yuya Wakamatsu are heavy.
Wakamatsu goes digging to the liver. Off that left hand, strike right down the center corridor. A beautiful counter from Wakamatsu. Sprawls out nicely, Wakamatsu. Presses him against the cage, on his back now.
Yuya got a little bit overexcited. He started to hunt. After he wobbled DJ a little bit, he went after him. And that was able DJ to duck under and secure that takedown. This is where DJ is very impressive. Watch him slowly make adjustments and work in his side control.
And he goes. He passes from half guard to side control. Tries to pin the arm. And Wakamatsu back to his feet. Well done from Yuya again. Tucks the back standing as DJ. Wakamatsu tries to turn back into him. What scrambles, what a contact. Now DJ wants to try and choke it.
Good job by Yuya. He's able to create separation in the hands, turn his back to his body, but he can't stop. He has to continually defend because DJ is relentless.
Demetrious Johnson more moves than U-Haul here in the second round. Referee Olivia Coast right on top of the action. Wakamatsu could be in trouble.
He looks like he's going for a choke. You can see he's got the side of the neck. It's like a no-arm triangle. But you can see that he's going for a rear naked choke. But good job by Yuya to scramble out of it. Now he's sitting in that. It was a bad spot. Look for the elbows. Watch the elbows on the ground and pound it. DJ, he doesn't want to lose this position. He chooses actually to leave mount and go into side control. And I know what he's looking for. He's looking for a kimura.
Fans. Big hello to all of our viewers in the US watching on TNT. Hope you're enjoying all the action of ONE Championship, all the action of Mighty Max, Demetrious Johnson.
She's framing off the face, just slides that elbow in. You can see he's trying to crucifix the arm. He's going to take that right arm of Yuya, put it between his legs so he can isolate, drop a little bit of ground. Here comes the kimura. He's looking for it. Good job by Yuya. Nice and tight on the arms.
Johnson hunting for a finish as we approach the halfway mark of this contest. As Mitch said earlier, it's been a long, long time since Demetrious Johnson has been in a three-rounder. Now can he tuck that arm home? No, not yet. Here's some knees to the collarbone. Demetrious on the Trojan. Can he get it? Can he get it? It's the title lead! Hold on. Wait a minute. Let me put some DJ in it.
Wow, he was able to get that choke from a nasty position. Didn't even have the full proper positioning. That's how tight the world champion squeeze is.
Demetrious Johnson, successful on his ONE Championship debut. And he moves through to the semifinals of the World Flyweight Grand Prix. That is why he's the greatest of all time. That's Mighty Max, Demetrious Johnson.
Look at this, has the guillotine. Yuya Wakamatsu did everything he could to try to avoid that, but look how tight that is. Look at the guillotine. You can see Yuya Wakamatsu tries to turn out of it. He tries to angle out, but look at that. Oh, that's a nasty position. That's how tight that is. Demetrious Mighty Mouse Johnson just moves forward in the ONE Flyweight World Grand Prix.
Have a look at the squeeze from Mighty Mouse. Locks out moisture, seals in freshness. Good night, Irene.
Well, Yuya Wakamatsu did a really good job in the first half of that match. He was stopping a lot of takedowns, showcasing good striking. Very impressive performance from Yuya Wakamatsu. DJ is the best flyweight in the world, and Yuya Wakamatsu was in there to the very end.
Let's go to Tom Lau, make it all official.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Olivier Coste, has called a stop to this contest after 2 minutes and 40 seconds in the second round for your winner by way of guillotine choke, Demetrious Johnson!
Welcome to ONE Championship, Demetrious Johnson. Takes his place in the semifinals of the World Flyweight Grand Prix.
Coming up after the break, mixed martial arts legend Eddie Alvarez makes his return. You're watching ONE Championship Weekly. Welcome back to ONE Championship Weekly. Also on the 7th of April, mixed martial arts legend Eddie Alvarez returns to the ONE Circle against Italian finisher Yuri Lapikus. Both men believe that an impressive win at ONE on TNT I will earn them a shot at ONE lightweight world champion Christian Lee. Alvarez is coming off a win against former ONE lightweight world champion Eduard Folayang. While the Filipino had Alvarez in trouble early, you can never count out the Underground King.
Ready? Ready? Choke!
Eduard Folayang, the former ONE lightweight world champion. Eddie Alvarez, former UFC and Bellator world champion. Wild hooking punches from both men, but Alvarez may have drawn the short straw on that exchange. Overhand right from Alvarez. Trying to lock on a guillotine early here. The wushu striking of Folayang. Hands like slabs of granite. And the leg kicks are thumping. And Alvarez can brawl, can get on the inside and make it a dogfight, make it vicious. The turning back kick from Folayang. He goes to the liver section. Gotta watch the turning liver kicks, gotta watch the cutting side kicks.
I like that left hook of Folayang right now. It's really trying to find a home on Eddie's chin. You can see him testing it, but Eddie says he wants to test Folayang's chin. Folayang's been knocked out tremendously in some of his past matches, and Eddie wants to test that. That movement fading already.
Folayang hooks the punch, then goes the uppercut off the right hand. A high round kick, the spinning back fist, the outside leg kick from Folayang. Putting together the combinations early on is Eduard Folayang of the Philippines.
Like those fans come.
Match brought to you by sponsor MG Motor. Let's go to Tom Lau to make it all official.
To present the fellow for this match, we have Senior Vice President and Director Marketing Communication Services of the Covenant Car Company Incorporated, Lynn M. Uena. And now, ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Olivier Cost, has called a stop to this contest after 2 minutes and 16 seconds in the first round for your winner by way of rear naked choke and advancing to the one lightweight World Grand Prix final, Eddie Alvarez.
Alvarez has a tough challenge ahead of him in the form of Yuri Lapikus. The young Italian boasts a 100% finishing rate and looks to maintain that perfect record against the legend. Lapikus first put his finishing instincts on show against Thai veteran Shannon Wirichai. It took a bit of time for the Italian to find his opening, but when he found it, Lapikus capitalized in an impressive fashion.
Third and final round. A touch gloves, the southpaw stance on Shannon Wirichai. The orthodox stance on Yuri Lapikus.
Had a good Iron Man thing there, but I don't do spoilers. Nice jab there by Shannon Wirichai. That's his ears a little bit. He has a little bit of damage on the left side of his head there on Wirichai. Lapikus can get king from that ground and pound. Nice inside leg kick from Wirichai.
Shannon throws the leg kick. He tagged Yuri with that run. Lapikus
Alvarez momentarily stunned and the flying knee from Wirajai. That's more like it from the Thai, the one shin, Shannon Wirajai.
And he used that one shin beautifully when he threw that left high kick and caught Lapikus on the side of his head. Now Lapikus is going to try to slow him down. You can start to see the urgency start to come out of Shannon Wirajai. Shannon Wirajai might see something here. Lapikus is getting backed up into the corner. Wirajai is being aggressive. Oh, nice takedown defense there from Wirajai. He might have a front headlock here. Let's go. Let's the hands go. You can see Lapikus starting to get a little bit desperate on that takedown. Lapikus might be tired, Michael Chiavello.
He's tired, and he's been hit cleanly several times here in the third and final round. This is all by my traffic. This is Shannon Wirajai now. Can Wirajai finish it?
Oh, beautiful.
That was to the liver. Folded him in half. That was a beauty from Wirajai. Lapikus gassed. Lapikus hurt. 3:30 remains in the contest. He's never been to the third. He's never been to the second. And he's feeling it now. Head rocks back. This one's over soon.
Shoots in. Good sprawl there from Wirajai. Good job by Lapikus to press Wirajai into that corner. You can start to see Wirajai starting to turn it on.
Two more clean shots and Shannon would have had it. That was a good way to get
this takedown.
Very clever from the Moldovan.
Shannon's got to get up, man. He can't lose this. He falls into the mount. Who has the bigger gas tank, Michael Chiavello? That's what this lightweight match is going to come down to. Lapikus in mount. Full control on Shannon Wirajai. He separates out. Now he's just going to drop down the elbows.
Here comes Lapikus again.
Hard position for Shannon Wirajai to do any sort of escape. Referee's going to call a hot to him. Looks like they're going to bring them back to the center.
Mitch, Wirajai had it going for a moment, and I don't want to spoil Avengers Endgame for you anymore, but let's hope that he doesn't do what actually happened at the end of the movie.
But yes, it is. Okay, now Wirajai is nice and tight. Now, the problem with this defensive strategy is he's trying to stall. He's trying to hold, wait for possibly a stand-up. He's got to put his hands on the hips like he's doing right there. Put his hands on the hips and start to scoot away, create bumps. He just might not have the pressure. Well, I don't know why he's crossing his leg, because that leg cross right there is actually a defense to when somebody's in side control to pass over. Shannon's got to start bumping. He's got to start bridging his hips up into the air to create some movement. He's only got 2 minutes left to work, and he was piecing up Lapikus there in the first 2 minutes of that match.
Oh, look at the elbows now from Lapikus. He is cut.
Oh, he gives up his back. This is what Lapikus wants.
This will be the beginning of the end now for Lapikus. So, Avengers Endgame. My man dies in the end. Well, Lapikus gets a third round win, the first time in his career. The man is 13-0, and I dare say, Mitch, first time out of Italy. We didn't know too much about him. The real deal, Yuri Lapikus is here.
Man, he showed us a lot in that match, and especially when he was in danger. Shannon Wirajai was hitting him with some big shots. He was coming forward, but then when Lapikus was able to get the takedown, and he was able to get on top, and then just start letting them fly. You can just see the ground and pound just cutting through the guard. Shannon Wirajai was forced to give up his back. And then Lapikus was able to lock up that rear naked choke. Look at those big old just punches coming down from all angles. You can see Wirajai was in trouble. Gave up his back right there.
Moldovan Beatles.
And then he takes the, look at that. And it's like, now that choke was in so tight, so fast. Wirajai had to tap his way out.
And that is going to delight Giorgio Petrosian, who is backstage warming up for that historic One Super Series Featherweight World Grand Prix. As the greatest kickboxer of all time is the trainer of Yuri Lapikus. Let's go to Tom Lau, make it all official.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Motohiro Tsurura, has called a stop to this contest after 3 minutes and 10 seconds in the third and final round. For your winner, by way of rear naked choke, Yuri Lapikus!
13-0 in a career dating back to 2014. 12 first round finishes, and now one in the third. Yuri Lapikus of Moldova via Italy, and Team Petrosian takes the winner's medal back to Europe.
On the 7th of April at 1 on TNT I,
Six-time ONE Flyweight World Champion Adriano Moraes defends his belt against ONE Flyweight World Grand Prix Champion and number one flyweight contender Demetrious Johnson. In the co-main event, mixed martial arts legend Eddie Alvarez takes on number two lightweight contender Yuri Lapakis. And four-time ONE Flyweight Muay Thai World Champion Rod Tang Jitmwangnon takes on Jacob Smith in an epic Muay Thai match. Check your local listings. Thank you for watching ONE Championship Weekly.